to your judicial record, because as I look at your judicial record, I am concerned as well. Recently, you determined that a state regulation that banned Bible study, that banned collective prayer, that banned worship in an individual's home, while at the same time allowing activities like in-home commercial filming, was neutral and generally applicable. According to you, according to the decision, apparently people who attend Bible study are a greater threat under COVID than movie stars when it comes to health and responsibility. Now, that decision, of course, went up to the U.S. Supreme Court. In 6-3, the Supreme Court said, no, you're wrong. What'd you get wrong?
The Supreme Court in Tandon has held that when you're looking at comparable activity, you look at the government interest that's asserted and not the reasons why people are gathering. That clarification has been very important. That is what I will fully, faithfully, and fairly apply going forward.
Why did you think that movie stars somehow are held to a different standard than people are coming to a Bible study?
I was following the Ninth Circuit precedent. They looked at all the restrictions on the movie industry and said that the risk transmission risk was lower because of all the restrictions. They had mandatory multiple testings per week, and they had a lot of restrictions that said that they had scientific evidence that
the
risk was lower.
Your opinion applied rational scrutiny to this restriction on religious freedom. The Supreme Court reversed that and applied strict scrutiny. There's a world of difference between rational basis and strict scrutiny. Again, why did you get it so wrong? And how can the American people have comfort that if you're a court of appeals judge, you will faithfully protect their rights to religious liberty?
I applied strict scrutiny as well, and I was following Ninth Circuit precedent at the time, which said you look at the risks of transmission and you go through seven factors to consider it. And at the time, the Sixth Circuit decision, which was not enjoined by the Supreme Court, said if you have a neutral, generally applicable rule that applies to both religious schools and public schools and other private schools, that survives strict scrutiny. And so the precedent that existed at the time is what I followed in issuing my decision.
Did you answer my second question?
I fully understand that Tandon is the law of the land. That is absolutely what I will follow, that you cannot assume the worst when people go to worship and assume the best when they go to work, and that you have to look at the government interest at stake, and that you all of the rulings and holdings in Tandon, that's the law of the land. That's what I will apply going forward in any case that raises these issues.
Thank you, Senator Cruz, Senator Ossoff, Senator Blackburn, and Senator Padilla.
Judge Koch.